Hi, how you doing? Zenobia here. I'm just getting ready to cook for my son, myself and my son. Just came back in from outside. It's a beautiful day. I thought I don't like doing videos. I really don't. But I thought I'd do this because it just needs to be addressed. This issue keeps coming up, like a bad vomit regurgitation on Twitter in particular with black people. So I thought, get it out of the way and just get on with your life, right? Might be easier said than done, but I'm just going to attempt. The video is called Black Lives Matter. Really? To who? This all began, well, today, the reason why I'm inspired to do this today is because I had some fool, I'm sorry, it wasn't a fool, I addressed somebody who tweeted a long list of injustices done by the presidents of America, a long list of presidents of America to the black people, against the black people of America. And I just, my thing is with this whole thing is, like, cut to the chase, just go for the money. It's about that. It's about, if it's about slavery, let's make it very specifically about why we have take issue with slavery. It's because blacks were made to work like dogs for free. Not even work, we were like enslaved, like really, a lot of us even murdered. Yes, and when I say us, I mean us too, because it's not just an American experience. We're forced to work for free. Built all of these white countries, these white cities and stuff, and like, my thing is very cut and dry. We worked, you didn't pay us, just pay us. It's very easy to trace us now. People are doing that. I don't understand why blacks are still taking to the streets with the invent of the internet technology and just rack this right up. Rack it right up. Bring it down to dollars and cents. And you know, once we actually start getting the money that they have to basically give you, because it's their laws in a sense that say they have, you know, they have to follow suit, then a lot of the other disrespectful things, including the murder of our boys in the streets, our children in the streets, will stop. Because once they see we are serious enough to get together as a collective and take care of our business, they will respect that like they do and go do whatever the hell it is they do whenever they do it, and so we can carry on with what we do as a race, as a people, whatever. So this person was angry at me, called me at one of those niggas, whatever. I guess meaning, you know, I'm half-stepping it with Black Lives Matter, the whole issue. But you know, black to me right now, but now Black Lives Matter is bullshit. And that's one of the reasons why, is because it's all about attacking people. Apparently, Black Lives Matter is this tiny, itsy-bitsy little radical collective of people who attack people every day on Twitter. That's what they do. They post their stuff, and if you don't like it, you can't have a healthy debate. It's just an attack. And then they block you, which says to me, you know, you're definitely not working with a full, with a brain in your head, because, I mean, you know, this stuff should be open to discussion, particularly with another black person. You know, you're attacking anybody who says all lives matter, if they have to be brown or black, whatever, anybody who's in the argument. And that I can kind of get, because you know what? All lives matter only happened because we brought about Black Lives Matter. They just want to diminish that. So I can stand it with, you know, people saying, you know what? Fuck your all lives matter or your other lives matter or whatever. It's about us. But it's actually not that anymore. It's become this very small collective of people who are extremely radical about making these points. I call them moot points because they have nothing to do with us getting anything. No, enough information. White people, black, other races, they don't care to hear all this information about what whites had and what they did to us. They don't care. White people know about it, and those brown and yellow people know about it too. They all know this false history. They know all these lies. So, you know, just stick to telling them that we were, for thousands upon thousands of years, we were kings and queens. They were living in caves. I mean, if you want to put information out there, talk about how great we were and are and will continue to be. Instead of diminishing our image, bringing it down to that of an ex-slave. Again, you know, if you want to make it about that, well then make it about reparations. And stop pissing and moaning. You know, I'm sick and tired of being attacked by these what I'm going to call now radicals, is Black Lives Matter and Black Lives Matter Toronto radicals. They don't support anything that I'm about. You know, I've certainly had a lot of problems that stem from racism here in Toronto and in Vancouver. And none of you Black people ever support me. I'm sorry, maybe one or two have in the past. I was even attacked, a horrible cyber attack on me and my son, by a white man who then got other Black American girls to strip us down to nothing, rip us apart, causing a great deal of stress and depression. And I only had Black men attack me. Which brings me to the other problem. Black men don't, in America, don't even like Black women. You hate Black women. And what is that about? That is going nowhere so fast. In fact, that will get you killed. Because the white man does not want you to have his woman. That was the basis of you being murdered a lot of the times, even long after slavery was over. And that will continue to be a good reason why a white man should want to kill you. You know, you hate us, you hate your own women, your own blood. But you must compare us to white women, that which belongs to your oppressor. Put her up on a pedestal, take her away from him. You know what you are? You're a sex pet. Black men who like white women and hate Black women are sex pets. You're just a monkey on a leash with a white woman for a limited amount of time. It's only a matter of time before the white man comes for your ass and whatever money he lent you. And yeah, it's board money. None of that money. Nothing belongs to you until or unless you become a part of our collective. Yes, you're our men. They're women. Until or unless you decide that we are worthy of respect and your time and your effort, and get your ass off the street there running around doing whatever you do, breeding up other Black women, breeding up white women, you know, whatever it is you do that is not taking care of business in your community, you will continue to be shot like a dog in the streets. Another point I want to make is, you know, who qualifies for this? Apparently, I'm Canadian. I haven't suffered enough, so I don't qualify to be a member of the Black Lives Matter movement. That's been said to me directly by a lot of Americans, because I'm not American, so I certainly don't know about the history of slavery or Black people. Excuse me, slavery did exist in Canada. Yes, as bad as it was in the States. You still believe the white man's lie when he says Canada, there was no slavery in Canada. There was slavery here. So I don't qualify because I didn't, by your standards, I didn't suffer enough. Really? That's so penny ante. Listen, suffering is suffering. They killed Black people here. They enslaved black people here, period. They did, it was colonization was all over the world. And slavery existed everywhere. So you don't like West Indians, you don't like Haitians, you don't like Africans. You want them out of America because they're taking all of your educational, all of your opportunities. Really? We're all the same people, just from a different part. It's we're a diaspora. We actually all come from that African experience. And if you're not a part of this, the Africans, well then why are you calling yourselves African American? What is with that? You have no connection to Africa? Africans are like, get out of my country. I just don't get all this discrimination coming from Blacks. I've suffered, me and my son, a great deal by the discrimination as a result of discrimination by the system. And not one of you support me. I could post till I'm blue in the face on Twitter or Facebook, whatever. None of you support me. But as soon as I have a difference of opinion where the approach is concerned, I'm a nigger. I'm a nigger, one of them niggers, whatever that even means. I don't talk like that, so I don't know. And no, that doesn't mean that we are different than you, or that I'm better than you. I just don't, you know, I just assume call you a nigger if you're acting like an idiot. because that's actually the expression in the proper expression in the dictionary. You know, and then I see other things that are just so inconsistent, like, you know, Beyonce doesn't have a right to take a stand. Like, what else does she have to do? Her and Jay-Z have spent hundreds of thousands of dollars bailing Black Lives Matter, you know, protesters out of jail. I think that she represents us very well, when, you know, with her latest work, Lemonade. You know, I think she is a queen by all standards, but apparently she's not good enough for any of you. She's one of you. She's American. I'm sure her lineage more than likely leads back to slavery. But still, she is not black enough, or she's not Black Lives Matter enough. She doesn't matter enough. You need to make up your minds, because you're just looking, you are looking like a terrorist group with no brains. You know, if we cannot do this as a collective, if the community doesn't matter, if education doesn't matter, if healthcare doesn't matter, if, you know, all of these other things that make up a community, a healthy community, don't matter, then we're going to get nowhere. And all we're doing is pissing and moaning and bullying people. That's what it comes down to. Black men, stop attacking black women. What is with that? Seriously, we need to get it together. Actually, no, we don't. I don't need to get anything together. I'm going to focus on what my family needs and X out the whole Black Lives Matter thing. Because even in Toronto, gay men, you're going to go after gay men when there are so many other things that really matter to black people. I'm done with this. I'm done. You know, I'm done suffering you people. Yes, I do people. And I'm done even using that hashtag or even addressing any of you. Until you all get your shit together, you're never going to have anything except discrimination and bullets by the same policemen, who, again, a lot of these people probably owe you reparations. It's stupid. I'm going to get on with my music now. I hope you all have a good day, and leave whatever comments or whatever, or don't. It doesn't matter to me. I just need to get this off my chest and get on with my day. I'm going to go cook something now for my kid. Have a great one. Bye-bye.